Now, there's been an interesting conflict of duality on earth in our existence, in human experience. And this conflict comes from largely this aspect of the male and the female. I mean, that's where the whole mental conflict starts. Because in nature, everything is divided into two, the male and the female. This is the beginning of conflict. If you perceive male and female as two separate beings, and we'll come to that, if today, possibly if the time allows, otherwise in the next session, we'll come to that. That's a very important element. Huh? But because of this inherent conflict of the opposites, male and female, opposite forces, inherent conflict, we started realizing, or I would say, look at the first attributes of both, or largely look at the attribute of feminine, because that's the dialogue is dedicated to that. The aspect of the feminine is, as I said, beauty, wildness, flow, love and compassion, creativity, and there could be hundreds of adjectives we can put to the feminine aspects. But when we come to the masculine aspect, there will be very few adjectives there. Somewhere, this is my feeling, that the male species felt that they realized that the female species is much more broader, powerful, because as the story also said, only in the female, the three gods believed that only a female can hold the collective energy of the three of us. So somewhere down the line, I think men realize that, or male species realize that, that in a way, she is very powerful. Yeah. Look at what we are doing today to the feminine energy. Let's take a clue from nature. Nature is considered as feminine energy. The forest, the rivers, the land, and the rest of it. What has been male trying to do? And male is just not male body. Male is the mental thinking. Yeah. What is humanity trying to do? Humanity is largely trying to tame nature. This is the word we use. We're trying to tame the nature. What is nature? Feminine aspect. Can it be tamed? No, it cannot be tamed. You try to tame her, she will revolt back. And she'll revolt back in such an aggressive way that you will lose your balance. Look around, sense it. Isn't that happening? That the male is trying to dominate, the male of the human is trying to dominate the feminine of nature. By trying to tame nature, we're building dams, we are cutting forests, we're trying to do everything possible to tame nature. We're killing the species of plants and animals and insects, which we don't understand how useful they are. We're just trying to eliminate because there's a danger. We're trying to protect ourselves because inherently the male consciousness is fearful about the female consciousness. Look deep in this. This is a very subtle, provocative, yet deep topic. If you're able to figure this out, if you're able to open this up in your consciousness, the conflict of duality within your being will start to dissolve. It's very deep rooted though. It's my humble request and suggestion to all of you, all the listeners, all the participants. In this entire dialogue, when I'm saying male and female, please do not look at the gender. Please do not identify yourself if I'm praising the female energy. And if you are female, do not boast yourself. I'm talking about feminine aspect of energy. I'm not talking about the feminine gender here. When I'm talking about the male, I'm talking about the masculine aspect of energy. I am not talking about the gender. So this is a clarification, friends. If you keep this clear in your mind, you'll be able to grasp what I'm trying to communicate. Otherwise, you will miss it within the internal debate of masculine versus feminine. Yeah, so think about that, stay with that, I would say, stay with that. Keep your gender biases, identifications and agenda on a side for the moment, right? Okay. Yeah, but the point I was trying to make is that the masculine attribute is always trying to control the feminine aspect, and the attribute of feminines are such that they cannot be controlled. Do you follow where the conflict arises from? Now, to complicate the matter a little bit in your consciousness, or to clarify it, go within as a single unit. Go within your own self right now as a single unit. Maybe you identify yourself as a male gender or as a female gender. Keep that aside for the moment. Just see within your own self where the conflict arises from, and you'll be very surprised to notice that your all inner conflict arises from the inherent conflict between the feminine attributes of your own energy and the masculine attributes of your own energy. It's within you, that's where the conflict arises. The masculine in you is trying to dominate and control the feminine in you, which is then represented in the outside world. As I said, we're trying to tame and control nature. And the feminine aspect of energy within you is, it cannot be tamed. That's the representation of the world outside. You push nature to tame the nature, to tame the forest, to tame the rivers. You push them, and a day comes when they break all the dams. They sweep you. Yeah? Because that urja, that energy cannot be tamed. That's a classic mistake humanity has been doing for thousands of years, trying to tame an energy which cannot be tamed. You need to have reverence for that energy. You need to have a affection or a prayerfulness or a gratitude towards that energy. You cannot tame her. That's where the conflict is.